all to the KEM Academy. So in today's video, we will discuss one question which is quite a theoretical question. The question is based on the concept of the molar depression in freezing point constant. Okay, the question was asked for NEET 2017. So the question is, if molality of dilute solution is doubled, if molality of the dilute solution is doubled, the value of molar depression constant KF will be, it will be half, the double, triple, or remains unchanged. We have to identify it. So first of all, to answer this question, we need to understand basically what is the meaning of molar depression constant. Okay, now if you study the depression in freezing point constant, you might be knowing that the depression in freezing point delta TF is proportional to molality of the solution. Delta TF is proportional to molality of the solution. Molality is nothing but moles of solute divided by mass of solvent in kilogram, mass of solvent in kilogram. So if I replace this sign of proportionality, I will have to put some constant of proportionality. Delta TF is equal to K suffix F into molality, where this KF is actually a constant of proportionality, also known as cryoscopic constant. This cryoscopic constant is nothing but a molar depression constant, also known as molar depression constant. So depression means what here? Decreasing freezing point constant. Okay, so actually when one mole solute is added to 1 kilogram of solvent, then in that case the value of delta TF is nothing but KF. Okay, because 1 mole in 1 kg, nothing but M is equal to 1 molar. And if I take 1 molar as a value of M, then I get this as delta TF is equal to only KF. So, depression freezing point constant KF is nothing but depression freezing point of a solution in which 1 mole of solute is present per kilogram of solvent. Now, basically, also you have to remember that this KF is property of solvent. Means what? Whatever solute you are adding, that solute will not decide the value of KF. What will decide? Only solvent will decide. And also, it depends on nature of solvent. KF depends on nature of solvent and does not depend on number of solute particles as well as solvent particle. So KF is the property of nature of solvent, not on the numbers of the solvent as well as solute. It depends only on what is the nature of the solvent, whether it is a polar, non-polar. Okay, depending on that we can get a different value of KF. But KF does not depend on the concentration. KF does not depend on the number of particles of solute. Therefore here, although I am making it double, triple, or whatever change I am doing in the concentration, okay, or in the molality, there will not be any change in the molar depression constant. So therefore, basically, it remains unchanged. Whatever the concentration is being changed, the KF value will not change. I hope you understood the solution of this question. So that's it for today. See you in the next video.